everyone. How much time I have?
4 minutes.
Okay. The last 2 minutes you can tell me, I will go to the closure. The main theme of my presentation is the necessity for the new Maitri station, and the existing Maitri has long back completed its useful life. During the 23rd Indian Scientific Expedition, we had the opportunity to visit Maitri as a part of this summer team, 2003 December to March 2004, and carry out the structural assessment of the Maitri station. I will skip this literature details. You will see the pictures. This is the Maitri station. And for those who are not familiar with the station, we have four important blocks, as you can see in the next picture. This is the which one I press? This is the main block, this is the A block, B block, and the C block. Those are the four blocks of the station. And this structure is supported on supporting columns, and these are the panels. I give the details in the next slide. The substructure is the supporting columns and framework, and the superstructure is marine plywood panels with polyurethane foam sandwiched in between. Okay, I am more comfortable with this. Yeah. Again, this also I will skip the details. I will show in the pictures. Mainly, we carried out measurements of thickness of all the supporting columns, and we did very detailed visual inspection wherein we could find cracks in supporting columns and other important aspects what we observed, we have listed in the report. And we also tried to carry out ultrasonic testing of marine plywood panels and how good is the insulation, and almost all the panels absorbed till there was nothing inside. And again, we carried out thickness measurement of all the 84 columns in the main block and 40 columns in the B block. And fortunately, the thickness measurements told that there is no corrosion in any of the columns. Absolutely zero corrosion. Also, because of the very clean environment you have, for corrosion to happen, you have to have two things. One is humidity, and one is a plentiful supply of oxygen. Even though you have oxygen, humidity for the structure is almost zero. And during the visual inspection, we also carried out detailed, when we are making thickness measurement, we also carried out detailed examination of all the supporting columns, and we have listed what were the observations we made, and mainly in terms of cracks and the locations of the cracks. And coming to the visual examination, as I told you, cracks were the main thing we observed, and the pathetic condition of the various blocks, especially the A block and the B block. The pictures will give you the status. And the, generally in structures, we measure cracks in components in terms of mm, and here we measure in terms of centimeters. Okay, and we also in structures, we also call as what we call as true thickness crack. For the entire thickness of the structure component, the crack would have penetrated. And here you can see, we had even true thickness cracks of almost the length of 20 centimeters, which is really, you just cannot think of that in structural columns. But somehow they have been standing there. These are some pictures of the columns with the cracks. You can see here A17 was probably one of the important huge crack we had, 50 centimeters crack. And other problems, maintenance related problems, which we always sort of neglect. For example, slow and accumulation of ice over years. You can see here how much problem it causes. It accumulates in the stilt, and the stilt area is expected to, we want free passage for air, wind. And that we have stopped. And in addition, this ice will accumulate and slowly push the structure up, all the floor panels up, and also the supporting framework also it has disturbed in many locations. And the block A, it was in such horrible condition, and it was recommended that it should be immediately replaced. You can see here some of the pictures of block A, and all the most of the supporting members also had completely given way, and even at the foundation level, there is absolutely nothing left.
you can see here, and during winter you can see seepage of outside temperature. It will not be warm at all inside the station, and you can see the condition of the supporting tie members. These are all A block. Another view of A block, and there are so many inlets, especially in winter for blizzards and for snow to enter the station, and therefore inside you cannot have the temperature maintained at all. And you can see here some pictures of even snow ingress and in a low intensity blizzard. What you see, these pictures were taken during summer, during our summer stay there, and you can just think of what happens during winter in these locations. And the C block, where we have the toilets, that again was in such pathetic condition that you just wonder how it is standing. Many members' wall panels were simply just hanging there, and there was no connectivity between the panels. And this is another block where which we told should be immediately replaced. This is a B block, where you have the dining and other facilities. Again, here also, especially the ice was pushing the structure up from bottom, and the floor panels, there was a separation of the panels, and the joints have given way, and there is no connectivity. You can see here, these are the, you can just see, you just cannot have any insulation of the structure when this is the condition of the panels outside. There are so many entries for outside cold air to enter, and absolutely insulation has no purpose there. And we also made many other observations which are useful, especially for the logistic team in the new station, also in future facilities. For example, what you call as structural members, they should be respected as structural members, and you just cannot simply keep using them for any damn thing which you think you can use it for. You want to use them as a stockyard, you have used them as stockyards. And you can see in the next picture, for example, in the beginning, from the Priyadarshini Lake, you wanted to take the water inlet, you wanted this insulation wooden box. You just cut the structural members and take the water inlet, which is something completely forbidden. And this probably there should be a way for the logistic people to tell the inmates of the stations that they should not, they may think that it is not important because they are not structural engineers, and they should not meddle with the components of the structure at whims and fancy. That is very, very important. Here also, it is completely wrong. We don't know. Just
What is the residual life you are giving now to the structure? Residual life. You have shown already that these are worse than the Charles of Bombay.
Yeah,
okay.
But
what's the residual life? What is the alarming point? Will it last?
Yes, I'm just coming to that. I'll go to that.
Ah.
You can see these pictures.
And your time is running out.
Yes. And we also gave a repair measures for the columns which had cracks. And we also collected data of acceleration, and our wind studies showed that this structure is wind sensitive. That also is another point. The structure has already expired its life, and it's wind sensitive. And again, the main conclusions: thickness measurements, absolutely zero corrosion, and mainly the column cracks in the supporting columns, and many columns had huge cracks of up to 50 centimeters. And there were many other problems in block A and block C, which I told need immediate replacement. And I come to the closure slide, where I just here I take just 1 minute. The station was put into operation in 1989, and with a 10 years design life. And you saw the condition of the station now, and it's already 30 years over. And also we recommended immediate replacement of load-bearing structural members, and also replacement of A and C blocks, which has not been done. And with all this, in one line summary, if you have to say, continuation of status quo is a high risk chance taking. Like we do listen to sentences even from many of us colleagues, oh, it has stood 30 years, absolutely no problem, we have been managing. Very, very wrong way, non-engineering way of looking at it. And I would just say one sentence: immediate replacement of Maitri station, is an inescapable necessity, and any continuation of usage of the station, especially those who are in charge of usage of the station, I am telling you, are please, you are taking a chance, let us not do that. With that, I end my presentation, and I also acknowledge all these people who have helped us in this presentation and also in the work. Thank you very much.